So we got a turtle, starboard side, 90 degrees off, about 100 yards.
We're looking for olive ridleys, we're looking for hawksbill and green turtles. One of the best things about having this boat is that we're able to bring scientists and documentary filmmakers out to really remote places, places that are difficult to get to, difficult to access, and often places that scientists can't afford to get to.
We protect the turtles that came here, that come here all the time. Actually, many of them live here. We are protectors of them, you know, and we love them. We love turtles.
We just got olive ridley, and we're gonna weigh her and make some measures, and we're gonna tag it with metal tags.
The large goal of this Eastern Pacific expedition is to gather enough information and evidence that sharks and turtles actually migrate from one location to the next location. So we're hoping to tag enough animals to be able to prove this.
The picture is closed right here.
That the main characteristic of Cocos is that it's very far from the mainland. So Cocos has not the influence of the anthropologic impacts. Also because of the system of currents, that there are currents that come from different sides of the island, and also because of the structure, because the structure in the bottom, they give the animals a lot of space to hide, and the quality of the water is very good here in Cocos. And the marine life is spectacular, especially fish, big fish, sharks, turtles, is the paradise for those animals.
So we had a really successful week. We, as the team, we were able to collect and tag 20 turtles, olive ridleys, and green turtles. We have lots of useful documentation, which we hope the scientists will be able to use to persuade the Costa Rican government to continue protecting this magical island.
A lot of us dream about having a time machine so we could go back 50 years, 100 years, 500 years to see what the Caribbean looked like before we humans really messed things up.
Jardines de la Reina, it's a quite isolated group of islands in the Cuban archipelago. And because it's far from land, but also protected by law.
In 35 years of diving, I've seen maybe one big shark in the water.
Basically, we have more sharks here in Jardines del Reino because it's just protected.
I lost track of the number of sharks here. I've never seen an ecosystem like this with so many top predators.
You know, sharks can be depleted very fast because of their life cycle. They grow slower, they're reproducing low number in comparison with other fishes.
There are a lot of political discussions about the U.S. and Cuba, and very often what you'll hear is that Cuba and the United States are separated by the Straits of Florida. There are strong underwater currents that connect our countries. Sea turtles, sharks, none of them have passports, none of them know anything about international boundaries. Now, I think one of the most important lessons here is marine reserves work. Here's living proof.
My name is Danielle Soreau, and I'm the winemaker for Cade Winery. I have the best job in the world. I love what I do. I love every aspect of winemaking. Looking at the grapevines, walking a lot, being outdoors, exposed. And then I'm back in the winery, working with my hands, making this grape juice, this grape wine. It's a very physical, labor-intensive process, but that's what I love. It's ever-changing. The wines are constantly evolving in the bottle, in the cellar, in the glass,